Greetings, beloved viewer. I come briefly today to discuss the fifth dimension, the integration of that new energy. We just went through the 11-11 portal Stargate that increased our level, our receptivity to love. And if you, whatever happened during this portal, if you were prepared for something and nothing happened, do not worry about it. Everything happened the way it was supposed to happen. And so now it's just a matter of tuning into the love, because we have this increased ability to do that. I have briefly discussed the first and second dimension, the metal, the realm of metal, of mineral, of vegetals, of animal. The third dimension, which is the world of humans right now, which is a holographic reality where that is perceived as real by the ego personality through the five senses of the human body, but it is actually a holographic matrix. And the fourth dimension is the astral plane, the dream world, the emotional world, and the fifth dimension is the point of connection between all aspects of self. So your fifth dimensional body, your fifth dimensional self, your soul, is already part of you. You are already part of it. You are it. And so it is just a matter of allowing your mental body to an emotional body to lose the polarity in order to be unified, so that you may enjoy all the incredible adventure that that your soul is seeking to integrate within you. And so it is from moving from a universe, because of course when we if we were to discuss the world of the physical to somebody who's non-physical, 10 minutes would probably not be enough to express all that this earth plane is about. And so it is the same thing in here. I cannot just can touch upon certain subject of the fifth dimension, but it is like a higher universe that is no longer a universe made of matter and particle, but it is a universe that is made of light. And so I'm not fully integrated within that energy yet. My mental body has been in the fifth dimension for many, many years, but my physical body, because of my earth life, I haven't been able yet, but I know it's getting closer to ascend, to integrate, to get the total clearing that will allow my whole physical ascension to catch up with my mind. And so, so the fifth dimension is a doorway, is a gate to a multidimensional way of living, an existence that is connected to many other realities. It is a hyperspace reality where many. It doesn't mean that we're leaving the world of the physical, but our perception is completely different. It's no longer polarized. It is crystalline and within a liquid light, a permanent state of love and well-being. But for that, we need to tune into the heart and seek that within ourselves, within the silence, within the peace. The peace, maintaining peace within yourself is essential to allow this new spirit to grow within yourself. And if there is conflict, if there is problem, do not worry about it. It's your soul that's sending you that to help you see what needs to be released, what needs to be let go. In order to assist, if you want to, there is invisible forces that are, of course, you have your guides and you have the creator, you have all sorts of archangelic and archangelic forces that you can call on, and once you call on them, know that they will respond. But they're also the fifth and sixth dimension is the realm of the higher civilization within this galaxy and around us. The Arcturian groups is wholly dedicated, and the spiritual beings that are wholly dedicated to human ascensions, like the Pleiadians and most of the Syrians, most of the Pleiadians. So depending on your soul connection, you connect to whatever soul group, soul family of star family you feel comfortable with, but know that those beings are eager to be in touch with you, to communicate with you. They may do that through dreams, they may do that through synchronicities, through impressions. There are many different ways, and the field of experience is going to open up as we open our third eye more. We are able to see so much more, And so it's about filling the energy within your heart and keeping your mind really clear and open so that you can see. I wanted to offer a little exercise. I'm sure I might have spoken of this before, but it is something you're going to want to do and maintain and work on and continue to do, is to never forget that you have a great sun. The sun, there is a sun outside in the sky, but there is also one in your heart. And so imagine, visualize, invoke, or see if you can, a sun that shines inside your heart with the eye of your mind. You look inside your heart and you see this sun shining, and whenever you're losing sense of who you are, you can just turn to that image, turn to that energy, and this will give you strength, this will give you power. As you breathe, you bring in energy to that sun and make it look, the oxygen will make it look brighter. So the more you can breathe consciously to fuel that energy, fuel that sun, fuel that light, it will keep you warm as well. It will take some practice before you can actually feel the warmth of that sun, but the light probably comes first when it comes to that kind of visualization. Once you have manifested that energy, you want to be able to connect, to let the energy flow all the way down through your feet to the center of the earth. There is a great bright sun that is pink light and a beautiful heart of Mother Earth. It is a bright shine, bright sun in the center of the planet in the fifth dimension. And then allow the energy to come back, mix with your sun, and then let it escape through your crown chakra, and it connects to this great central sun, this great white sphere of white light, and then it can you bring it back and work with those energies. Those are things that need to be exercise that needs to be done and repeated. The second exercise I've already mentioned is very important to do it at least once a month. It is for your well-being, for your sense of freedom. It is the exercise I will repeat. If you've done it before, you already heard that story, but it was given by Archangel Michael, I believe. It's an exercise that you visualize, you close your eyes, you sit down, you relax, you breathe, and you visualize yourself in a circle of light in a very very dark room. It's a very big room, it's all dark, you are the only one in the light. And in this room there is all the people you've ever met. All the people, if you've done it in a month ago, all the people you met since the last month. So you realize that all those people had judgment when they looked at you, when they talked to you, they had conscious and unconscious judgment, and all those judgments are tying you up like a mummy, and they're like closing and closing you. And so then an angel comes in with a special scissors, and he cuts through all the judgment, all those little wrapping, and all those things return to all the people that judged you, and then you send a wave of violet light so that it's transmuted, and they don't even feel like the judgment was. So that you help them because you do not want to judge. See, most of the entanglement that we have here comes from self-judgment and judgment towards others. So it's very important to be as much as possible to be outside of judgment. You can also ask to be guided. It's very important to ask to be guided and to follow the guidance, not to resist the flow, because the flow is sometimes we want to resist, but if you allow whatever energies to unfold, there will be a dance of energy that will eventually come into harmony. So it's about connecting to each moment, but sometimes you will see that one moment you are guided towards something to the right, and then the next moment you felt really good about going to the right, but the next moment tells you, no, you got to go to the left. So, no, I want to go to the right. That's fighting against the flow. If you have to let go of the right and then go to the left, and then once you're in the left, you will probably realize, well, that's in the right that I wanted to be. So, you're going back there. But allow yourself to work with the energy. Understand sometimes there is dichotomies, energies that wants to, we are pulled in two different directions, and so you have to give it sometimes and allow your soul to take over, to show you the way, to ask spirit as God, as the angels, to show you the way, to make your life graceful, to make your life easy, for the fifth dimension is a path of grace and ease. And so oh yeah, another just took some notes because I have to do videos in French and English, so I otherwise I would be purely spontaneous, but I want to keep the messages aligned. So I also wanted to say that in third dimension, love is often felt when we lose something. We were in love and then the person leaves and so we lose it, and so that's why we feel the love, and so we have this very strange relationship to love. But when we connect to our heart and we feel the fifth dimension, there is the separation no longer exists. You can reconnect to anyone at any time. You cannot control other people's thoughts and behavior, but you can, if once you are connected in your heart, there is no you can never be fully separated. Everything is interconnected. Everything is one, and so understand that all relationships are eternal. Of course, there are relationships that have been forgotten, but they may pop in from your cellular bank, from your cells, that within your DNA. So a memory of something past may come back. So all the old relationships need to be pacified, need to be forgiven, so that when they come back, they don't bother you. So you may just ask in your intention to put golden light in all your connecting links throughout all your relationships, throughout all time, in the all past, all present, all future. And as we do that, we move into a state that is more settled. That is the outcome. That is the more settled we become, the more sense, the closer we are to the truth, because the truth of the light is so subtle, it's invisible, it's completely unnoticed, and even when we discover something, there are more subtle realms beyond that always. So it is very much about refining, tuning in, and of course you have spirit guidance to help you. It is not always easy at first to accept that, but it is part of your higher self to be connected to those beings that will help you blaze the way and to free yourself, because we're going to be emerging into this fifth dimension. But we have to make it our will to move in that direction, to choose love and unity, to understand that fear and separation are illusions. And so from the more we are able to do that, the easier the path comes and goes, and everything can come and go. There is no there is no more need to hold on to anything, because all is there and all is recalled at any time. I hope this video was interesting for you. I wish you a wonderful day in connection to this higher love, this higher life that we are. And so in this unity, I send greetings and my love to you. Blessed be.